You've been hearing a lot about Azure Arc, but what is an Azure Arc enabled managed instance? Learn more in today's episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Vin Yu, a program manager on the Azure Data team. Thanks for joining us today, Vin.
Hey, Anna, thanks. I'm happy to be on the show.
And we're happy to have you. And today we're going to be talking about Azure Arc enabled managed instance. And, you know, this has been, you know, a lot of buzz about this Azure Arc and Arc enabled managed instance. But, you know, I have one question to kick us off. Like, what is that?
So if you're familiar with managed instance, this is pretty much the ability to run this anywhere through Azure Arc. So this is going to enable you to bring your SQL Server workloads and run it anywhere and have the ability also take advantage of some of those Azure SQL benefits that you have in Azure as well. So some of those managed capabilities such as monitoring and some of those security benefits as well. And most important of all, it runs anywhere.
Okay, cool. That sounds pretty cool. I'm interested to learn a little bit more. I think you brought a few slides. Do you want to go ahead and share and take us through some of the details?
Yeah, for sure. Let me just show you my screen. Before we go into too much of the technical details, let's just take a look at, you know, some of the reasoning why you might be interested in taking a look at Azure Arc enabled managed instance. So if you take a look at the environment today, our customers are running many different applications with many different architectures, some of them using VMs, some of them using containers, which is fairly new, and increasingly so. Some customers are even running in some form of serverless environment as well. And of course, you could, as with time, customers are now running with many different application languages as well. Now, over time, not only does the architecture of the application is changing, we're also seeing a very diverse set of infrastructure as well. Customers have multiple branches for their expanding businesses. They're running it in multiple data centers, not a single data center. They're leveraging different OEM hardware. And now we're seeing even an increase in running on the edge or different edge applications as well. Now, to solve some of these problems with the sprawl of the different apps and the diverse infrastructures, customers are actually taking advantage of the cloud. Now, some customers are actually able to move their entire workload to the cloud, which greatly simplifies a lot of their management headaches. But we also understand that a lot of our customers and you as well may be running your application across multiple clouds, or you're only able to move part of your application to the cloud and you're still not able to move all of it, right? Or there's many different reasons why you can't use the cloud at all altogether and you would love to leverage some of those benefits. And this is where Azure Arc comes in, because this is going to, the premise of what we're really doing here is bringing Arc outside, bringing Azure outside of the Microsoft cloud into your data center. So you could run Azure technologies in the environment of your choice. So what does that mean for Arc-enabled managed instance, right? So if you're familiar with managed instance, one thing that you'll note on the very first tile here I have that about this product is that it's always current. As with managed instance, this product is always current. It is a evergreen version of SQL, and it will have automatic updates provided for you. One key difference here and a benefit of this is it's going to be fully controlled by you. So you could choose when to upgrade. For example, let's say you want to updates be applied to all your instances on Saturday at 3 a.m. You can do that as well. The second is that elastic scale. So just like in Azure, how easy it is to spin up new instances, you can also do that with Azure Data Services enabled through Azure Arc. And you can scale up and scale down as you need for your managed instance while maintaining the uptime that's required for your applications to run. And there's automation at scale for the various tasks. For example, you want to do backup at scale. You want to do all these security threat detections at scale. This is all possible through this as well. And last but not least is unified management. One of those key points I talked about earlier was that you have, like, some of our customers have some of their assets on-prem and some in the Azure. If you go to the Azure portal, you could view all your Azure SQL resources, which includes Azure Arc-enabled managed instance. And you could use some of the other familiar tools to manage your database as well. For example, Azure Data Studio, SSMS, or you could use the different tools that you already exist, you're already using. And all of this works in any on any hardware, on any Kubernetes. And you could run it in a both fully disconnected fashion or a connected scenario. And so just to take a look at, you know, from at a glance on what this looks like, you know, that's required for you to successfully run Azure Arc enabled managed instance. First, what we require is that you bring in your hardware and your Kubernetes. So you have the choice of hardware that you want. So whether you want to provision your hardware from Azure Stack, you know, your own, your existing hardware, or on another cloud, that's all possible. On top of that, all we require is that you have Kubernetes. So you could choose a variety of Kubernetes options. So here I have listed AKS as one that's on Azure, and vanilla Kubernetes. And then from there, this is where we start bringing in some of that magic. So first, the first thing that you'll do to, in order to use Azure Arc Data Services is that you would lay down this data controller. In the middle here, you see the Azure Arc management piece. And this is going to help you do all those things such as provisioning, set up HA. It's going to provide backups, updates, diagnostics, and all the other Azure goodness as well. And then from there, you could just provision your various data services, which includes Azure Arc enabled managed instance. And you could connect to it using the apps of your choice.
Thanks, Vin. This is really interesting. You know, there are a lot of game changers, but there are really two things that stood out to me, at least at first glance. One is this idea of getting, you know, evergreen or versionless SQL outside of Azure, or kind of like wherever you are. That's a huge game changer. And the other game changer to me is kind of how you can use the same skills that you've been using for SQL Server, but now you can use them on top of Kubernetes, you can use them on top of other clouds, but you're still going to be able to get things like versionless SQL and that management that before you could only get in Azure. So that's really cool. I would love if you could show us an example of this in action.
Yeah, for sure. So let me go ahead and get to my demo. So here, what you see on my screen is my Azure Data Studio, and this is, I'm actually connected to my Azure Arc data controller, and this data controller helped me provision all the Azure Arc enabled managed instances. So here you can see on the very top, I have some, you notice here, it looks actually quite like Azure, where it's showing things like name, the region, the resource group, subscription IDs, and this is all of what you would see in Azure as well. And this is because I have my instance connected to Azure at the moment. So you see some of these properties pop up. And here in the bottom, you can see a few of the Azure Arc enabled managed instances. So let's go ahead and take a look at one of them. So I'm going to click on MIAA demo. And here again, you also see a very similar set of essential properties at the very top. But on top of that, one thing I'd like to really point out here is actually these service endpoints here. I have something called a Kibana and Grafana dashboard. And one of those things I mentioned earlier on was that we are trying to take some of the goodness of Azure, at least some of those ideas as well, and bring them to you no matter where you are. So if I click on Grafana dashboard, and what this is a monitoring dashboard that's built into the product. So for every Azure Arc enabled managed instance, we're actually providing a built-in dashboard for all those monitoring needs. So let's take a look at the last hour here. And you can see that just quickly before, earlier in point in time, you can see that I have some transactions per second, right? So there was some data workload, and it stopped about 30 minutes ago, just right before I were having this conversation here. I didn't want to take up my internet bandwidth. So you can see that's all happening, and that's good. So we have all these different ways we're actually providing monitoring experiences for you. So things that you care about, like wait stats, different database activities, SQL Server activities as well. So this is just one of those things I talked about in terms of bringing the goodness of Azure to you, no matter where you choose to run your workload. And over time, what you're going to see is, so we're just really just scratching the surface here on this page. We only have the monitoring capability shown for now, but over time, you're really going to see a lot more built in. Now, if I go to our portal as well, one thing you're going to note is that I have exactly the same MIA demo resource open here, and I have this on this page. And notice I have a very similar trend of of my activity that was happening about an hour ago, and it stopped just about half an hour ago because of this call. But notice here, you know, you're also able to monitor your instances in Azure as well. So if you could connect all your resources to Azure, you could manage it all from a single pane of glass. And this is one benefit of where we're trying to unify the management experiences as well.
Thanks, Vin. That's really cool. You know, I like how you showed us how we can see, you know, you kind of proved it was the same database because you showed us in the Azure portal and in Azure Data Studio. And I think this service is available in preview today. So it's really cool to see the progress. I'm sure there's lots of more things coming down the pipeline and lots more things we haven't even seen today. But if we want to give our users something to do or something to get started with, what do you think the best way to get started with this would be?
I think that given that this product is constantly evolving, we share some resources and links in this video below. So do check those links out. We keep that date, so you could check out the latest and greatest there.
Awesome. So not only can you get versionless SQL anywhere, but you can also get versionless documentation.
Yes, for sure. That's always kept up to date.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much for being on the show today, Vin, and sharing with us Azure Arc-enabled Managed Instance. I learned a few things, and I'm sure our viewers did as well. For our viewers, if you like this video, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and leave us a comment and let us know what you think of Azure Arc-enabled Managed Instance. We hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.